Welcome everyone. I'm back here. Jamie back here for yet another Coca-Cola OSL. Bring you back the old, good old days of Brood War back in 2001. This is going to be day one of Ground of Eight. So how this works, guys, is it's actually quite simple. So pretty much we have just finished the round of 16, and we are now doing Group A and Group B. So how this operates is that they do it by days, not by groups. So it's pretty much how it works is that every player plays each other once. And then whoever comes up on top of that record will move on. So people in Group A, I want to assume this is just a random draw. Potentially, I don't even know how this actually operates, but it's going to be V, Gundam, Isaac, Jinnam, and Enough in Group A, and then in Group B, Sync, Boxer, Into the Rain, and Yellow. So this is actually going to be a pretty good, pretty fun, pretty fun and interesting group right here. With we're going to start off with Isaac versus Enough. I believe unless we're going to have some crazy shenanigans by Isaac to randomly go ZVP on us, I would assume that he's going to go ZVZ, but that is fairly peculiar. I can't say it. My goodness. My goodness. All right, so I know that's Isaac in the right hand but this is, the fact is that Isaac, I can't grasp my hands around this guy, because what did he do, PvP, and then he does ZBZ, so his only, he does ZBT, ZBZ, PvP. Why is that? Why would you? Those are actually the two matchups that I would rather not play mirror matches. If I was to go into the mentality of a pro gamer and be like, all right, how can I verify, like, I am the best player? My best chances I would feel like to be winning if I was like a really good player and I thought my abilities are really good would be if I'm Terran, for example, right? I would play Terran, because let's just say for the sake of argument that all the races are completely... Oh wow, I'm sorry. I'm very sorry. I didn't know my volume was turned down so low. But anyway, so I was talking about the fact of Isaac being such a weird player, because where was he at? He was at again, PvP, ZVZ, and then ZVT. And my mentality would be, why would you want PvP and ZVZ, where they're kind of more of a, maybe not PvP, not as extreme as ZVZ is, but it's just a build order win. I mean, really, that's sometimes what it comes down to, of how terrible that is. And that's kind of how, I mean, at least modern day Brood War has been. At least in the PvP, again, not so much, but it can be a build order win, more so than other matchups. So what it comes down to is, if I was to be, again, if we're, for the sake of argument that all match of all races are balanced, I would choose Terran, because TVT, it's not like you're going to kill each other in the first 5 minutes. It's you have long methodical battles that will end up being tank lines, which is your fault if you win or lose. And then Terran versus Protoss and Terran versus Zerg aren't just build order wins, they're more strategic positioning. So I just wonder what Isaac was actually originally thought about if his career of being a pro gamer would actually continue, because PvP, you could argue that it's more build order based than other matchups are, which you wouldn't want, because then it's not your ability that's winning, it's just luck of the draw, hey, I just got off this build order, then I just got a build order win. And ZVZ, I don't know why you would ever want to have ZVZ. I mean, other than the fact that, I mean, it's entertaining and it gives you adrenaline rush, of course, but again, build order wins most of the time, I would say. I mean, of course, if you're way wicked good as Zerg, you'll win, but yeah. These are new, I think. These are new stats. Age 19, Isaac's 19, 1 year older than I am at the currently. If you look at this, yeah, I would have been 2001, 2000. That was 11 years ago. I would have been 7. I would have been 7 at the time. So he's a bit older than I am. Now, for the fact it's going to be Isaac versus Enough. I don't know. I'm just going to go with Isaac because I've casted him the most recently. Neo Valhalla. Very interesting for ZVZ because there isn't... To this day, I don't really know how island maps really affect of what the proper build orders are. I mean, I've seen PvP a lot where it will go into, like, at least modern day, island PvP would be, like, a lot of scout carrier stuff going on. But Zerg has the opportunity to go quick mutilus, go into lurker drops, go into drop play a lot, actually, as well, just continuing to bring in mass lane. That can also work, too. So we'll see really how it works. It's more Hydra just based because you still need to deal with Mutilus in some regard. So we'll see what the choice. I believe Enough was a player that did decide to go that more drop heavy style in ZVZ, if I'm not mistaken. I could be wrong about that. And of course, we will learn as we go on. But... Cool. And it looks like that was the ending, and here we go. We're going to introduce the players right here. It's going to be good, guys. I'm expecting a good ZVZ between these guys. Let's do this. Oh, man. Okay, so... On the left, if we have a closer shot, it will be enough. They both have pretty long hair, but that it will be enough. Enough, not as cool as Isaac's, just because of his. I don't like his glasses, but that will be enough. Does he got some nice flow going right there? Too bang heavy though for me. And we just get the crazy-eyed, the awesome Isaac player right here. I believe his right eye is a little bit more messed up, or is a little has a little bit of an issue, but who cares? We're going into this Coca-Cola OSL. Thank you for sponsoring StarCraft 13. 10 years ago? 11 years ago. And here we go. Zerg versus Zerg on Valhalla. Let's do this, guys. Neo Valhalla. Enough will be the teal Zerg on the right-hand corner right here. That will be enough. At the 3 o'clock position right here. And on the left, it will be at the 9 o'clock position. It will be the white Zerg, Isaac. Actually, same colors versus Isaac versus I'm trying to figure out this one. Isaac again. There we go. It was actually the same colors as Isaac versus Into the Rain for the tiebreak matches. But regardless, we are here now, and we'll see how this goes. Really, I would stray at these positions. Because, I mean, they'll find out that they're going to be really... I mean, they're not going to be close by air positions at all. So I wouldn't think drop play as heavily. I would honestly think more meatless space for both players. We'll see, of course, as anything. They could completely disregard. And my analysis, of course, is kind of crappy, so... I just do this to enjoy some Brood War, and the fact is that they don't have English broadcast for this. If they did, I wouldn't have to speak at 8 o'clock at night and drive my whole house haywire for me commentating over some old Korean video. But, alright, And they're talking about some positional reasons and stuff like that. I want to say those are overlord paths to those locations. If you guys don't know, that mineral patch right here, right over here where my cursor is, doesn't have gas. So where that can be an issue, for that, oh, we already have a quick gas. I honestly, it's a race to layer tech regardless, because you need, either you go meatless or you go drop play, so it's, you need both. You need layer tech for both, so I'm not surprised for gas first from both players, because, I mean, why else would you go pool, why would you go pool before extractor, because you're not going to have to worry about at least a a 9 pool just coming right at your door, or 4 pool at least. So, while definitely might be one of the reasons why I might prefer Island ZVZ, just because it's, I guess, it's still, I guess, build order, but at least it's is more interesting than just Lings, because at least you have an option to go either blind, either blind drop play or blind mutalisks, which is more interesting than 10 seconds later than 10 seconds of your pool later, which will determine a game win or loss. I'm really trying to position my microphone in a better position, but if I move it too much, it becomes too heavy, and then it topples over, which you may have heard, and I'm trying to reposition it now. Alright, no, that is too far. That is too far. Hold on, I'm trying to figure this out right now. I cannot figure this out. I cannot figure this stuff out right now. Point is, my goodness, I cannot keep this straight. Give me a second, guys, I apologize. I cannot keep this straight. Here we go. Oh, I know why he was doing that. Okay. Alright, I found a good position now. Alright, so it will be Spire for both players. Absolutely trash right there. From what I did. And again, I apologize if it deterred from my awesome English casting of this awesome PvP epicness or something, whatever you want to call it. But identical build orders of what so it seems. Both players will verify that it is Spire. Again, seems like the most logical choice because of the locations and Evo Chamber coming up right here. So Isaac maybe are... it looks like enough will just be able to put himself in the position of being aggressive. While it may seem that Isaac is looking to play a bit more defensive in this position right now, with the Evo Chamber, because he's going to get up a couple of supports for that, and there goes down a creep colony right to the left of the Evo Chamber. So he doesn't feel confident in his ability to defend against these meatless right now. Maybe he feels behind, or Scourge. Or Scourge, I guess. And you guys remember, like, you may be questioning, like, oh, maybe Mutalisk would have been better, but Scourge on Scourge, because Mutalisk micro hasn't been founded yet, it makes sense to a degree, I guess. And it looks like he does have drop now, so he will be taking expansion. Putting him on a low ground right there. Scourge on Scourge action happening over there. If it's really needy, I guess. But alright then. And he's going to get his own spore. Alright, so one spore for each. I mean, alright, here come the Mutalisks now, though. I don't think I could handle This is kind of ZVZ with your scourge, because I wouldn't know what to hit with them. And I'm going to be going for that overlord right here. We'll be showing that he does have a good amount of mutilus out, though. So what does that mean for enough right here? We did see enough, did decide to go drop down these drones, but where are they headed? That is the question, as I'm not seeing any base being taken. Quite yet, at least. I don't know what the reasoning for that is. And, alright, enough is going to start getting up his own. And there we go. Okay, so enough will be expanding in the top right-hand corner around that 2 o'clock position right now. Hasn't been spotted yet by Isaac, I don't believe. Isaac will be moving all of his overlords in the center of the map, though, of what it seems. And all right, but that's really, I mean, if Isaac doesn't get sniff that out, this is going to be actually really bad, because that's one more base, that's one more gas, more importantly, that Isaac will have, or excuse me, what enough will have right now. But it looks like, oh, is he double expanding? Very interesting. Enough is playing unbelievably greedy right now. We'll see if it will work, but I mean, at the same time, Isaac's going to take the center base. And he's double expanded himself in the top left at that 10. All right, then, we're in for a macro ZBZ, guys. An island, all right. I'll be interested. But again, it might just come down to a huge mutal flock fighting each other. This is setting up for a very interesting game if this game goes on, but this is the problem with doing that. Really, he's just gonna leave the base alone. He's worried about the Scourge, I guess. Worried about the Scourge, so we'll be pushing out here. Mutalists are looking, they're gonna be en route to that other base. Looks like they know. Could potentially clear off. Something going on here. It's so confusing of what the right call, because I just don't know. And I apologize for not exactly knowing what to do. But there's a lot of Scourge out for enough right here. He's invested a whole lot in there. He's going to clear off a couple of these overlords just right here, and he's found the center base. What will Isaac do to respond right here? Just push back his own mutalists right here. Both players are just afraid to kill off each other's hatcheries right here, which is what I'm kind of actually hoping for, because I want to see what this will evolve into. A late-game ZVZ. You rarely ever see this kind of game. Checking out those awesome 4x3 flat-screen monitors right there. I feel like my left monitor, like my old 2003 monitor, would be like so high-end for that time period. I'm still surprised I still have this monitor. Okay, then. We'll see where we go from here, as they're both going to have the three gases here. So what I'm going to assume is that Isaac will just have a lot of Scourge available. Because I can't imagine a ton of droning happening right now, especially with the Mutalist being able to fly around at any given time. I mean, he's taking all the gases, so it looks like there'll just be a huge, huge amassing Scourge at this point. It looks like that's how the ZVZ is going to end up being. Unless they're going to go for some random defilers, but I think that sounds crazy in its own right. And oh, here we go. Enough is going to be pushing in here. Oh, we'll decide to engage entirely. All the Scourge will connect, but doesn't look like it's enough. I think Isaac will have more mutas right here, but it's hard to tell who's going to win this engagement. And it looks like enough will be. Enough will have to retreat here, and Isaac is gonna look really good. Oh, that was enough right there. I mean, Isaac's gonna look really, really good right now. Gonna be going into swooping in and gonna just kill off these spores right here and go for the hatchery. No, he will not. Two spores are gonna be too much for him. Enough will be trying to chase off Isaac's needless right there. Isaac will retreat down to his center base right here. Looks like he will be taking that fourth gas at this time. But Isaac's going to look into really... Isaac is looking really good. If he can get up that fourth gas, he's going to have... He's going to be able to utilize all the larva for Scourge if he needs to, which are going to be fine for needless battles, because the Scourge... I mean, there's going to be... Neither player is muted microing. At least against Scourge, I think. And there's some of the link drops right there. Didn't do anything, but... And he's going to be going in here. Three sports this time. Does he feel confident in his ability? We do see enough coming in here with the Scourge. Oh, and taking way too many casualties for that. Was it worth it? Only getting enough three spores right there. Does Isaac think it's worth it at all? If he can clear out these needles, then maybe he can kill off this hatchery. But with the dropping of the lings, he can target fire that hatchery, and it's going to go down. So definitely worth this right here. Going to be cutting off that supply of that third gas for quite some time. Will he actually get the hatchery? Oh, it's almost killed off. I don't know how much HP it has left. 45, I think. Around 40 HP left on that hatchery, if I can barely make out those numbers. But it appears that it will survive. If he can just bring in like two more meatless right there, he could get the kill. Is this going to forfeit them? Can he get him in there? Oh, such a shame, too. He just needs to muta bomb that one more time, and he'll get that. The hatchery snipe. But even more importantly, those larvae are either going to go to more units, or they're going to go into drones. But either way, he's going to be behind Isaac at this point in time, as he's off of four gas. And I'm just so surprised, though, like, why both these players will just see an Overlord and then just retreat from it. I don't know if that feels, if that, like, brings unneedy aggro to their opponent or something, but I don't know. I feel like you would want to erase all the Overlords of your opponent off the field, but apparently not.
Okay.
Interesting PvP, but again, he's not deciding to kill off that 4 o'clock position, which it's beyond me why he's not. But okay, maybe that Overlord actually may house something in it. Oh, and another expansion going down for Isaac right now. Isaac is looking really, really good right now, and if enough can maybe pull something, who knows, going to the Queen's Nest, Hive Tech, something I've never seen in a PvP, in a ZBZ, excuse me. So if the Queen's Nest can go up and get the Hive Tech ready, will we see Greater Spire? Because again, what would you go? Devour? But the Scourge will just rip apart Devourers. Except Devourers don't really... I don't know the actual purpose of Devourers at all. I mean, I understand that they shoot off the spores to slow down units, but they'll just die from like 4 or 5 Scourge hits. Which I guess in itself might be worth it, but oof. Maybe we'll see a Devour on a pro game. If you want to call this pro game. He doesn't... He's getting his Hive too. Okay. Oh, look at that. In the bottom right-hand corner, we have enough, I think, taking a base down there. I'm not sure if it's just been placed down there, but it looks like Isaac will know about that very shortly, as it looks like his meatless are going to be coming in here. A lot of Scourge are going to be connecting right here. Will they hit? Oh! I was going to say that would have been perfect, like, trapping them all in there. Taking a little bit of fire from from Isaac's meatless undo enough. Click on that bottom right hand base. Yeah. Oh, he knows about that base for sure. But Isaac has to make a rational decision of does he go down there, potentially exposing his own bases. And that's the reason, I guess, why he doesn't want to go out there kind of fetching off for Overlords, just because he doesn't want to be cut out of position, because his own drone line could just be massacred in a matter of seconds with 20 meatless just flying in there. But Isaac is positioning himself in the north right here, going to be clearing up an overlord. Now going to be doing that, though. But we need to see enough doing something right here. As he's, I mean, he's going to get up with that fourth gas eventually, but greater spire, so it will be devours. But we have double spire from an Isaac right now.
Huh.
I don't think we have double spire. So he may get greater spire tech after his upgrade is done. That's probably why Isaac's probably waiting on that. But oh my goodness, Isaac has so many mutilists right now. That must be like three control groups worth. Oh, that's so many scourge. Oh no. Oh. Well done by enough to really position his scourge in such a way. Isaac will retreat back to his center base right now. But we'll see if the devourers will do anything.
Hmm.
Wow. Just wow. Do we see? Those will be devourers. It's just how effective those will be. Again, Isaac, you monster! You finally did that. And he's just gonna lift up the rest of his drones. He doesn't care about the base anymore. He's gonna go in the bottom right hand base. Start saturating that. Makes sense. Instead of waiting for the 92nd, I think, for the hatch rate to come up, which is actually a really big deal right now. Yeah, so there are the devourers. It's just, why would you use them? That's kind of the question, I would assume, but devourers will be out. Does he have Scourge with him? I'm very excited because the Devourer was always that unit that was always kind of my favorite unit against computers because I never really saw a reason to use them, but I always did. Along with the Defiler because I never knew what Dark Swarm did before I started playing online, but oh, taking a lot of fire right there, but there's so many mutilists out. I'm not sure if it really matters if this devours. The devourers got to come in here. Do they do the splash damage, though, on the air, though? That would be the interesting thing. Getting a nice face shot of enough right there. I wonder how long Asport stays out there, but as you can see, he's going to get the Scourge out to deal with those devourers, as it is the right move. I just feel like if he just masses up Scourge, I mean, he'll be fine. No, apparently, the Greatest Spire's almost killed off. Interesting. Nope. Sorry, I just don't even know what to talk about right now. But okay, so we're gonna have Isaac gonna be going in here, pushing in here. Can he get off? Can he just snipe off the extractor? Maybe even the hatchery? Will there be enough? It looks like enough is gonna be coming from the south. With his meatless, the devourers will be trailing behind ever. Just barely. Oh, and the Scourge might be in position to kill them off. There's so much Isaac on the field right now. But it looks like Isaac will be going off to the west for the time being. And we'll retreat back to his center base right now. Guess both players are just kind of going to have to max 2-1 upgrades for Isaac at this time. As it's so hard to read, I realize that. And that's not an Isaac base. That was a enough base in that 6 o'clock right there. He's going to get his own Greater Spire for himself right now. His main base has been mined out. Probably the exact same for enough right now. Has enough. Done it. Can he secure that 6 o'clock? Isaac has to do something either to respond to that 6 o'clock base, which he's seen. He now sees it. I believe he sent a task force of mutilists down there. No, but there's big engagement happening over there. over by the 2 o'clock position, and he's going to reposition himself more down southbound. Makes sense because he needs to defend that base, but God, that's a lot of meatless. They're all going down to the 6. He knows that he needs to kill it off in order to stay in this game, and that's exactly what he's going to be doing here. But it looks like Enough is going to try to intercept this with his devourers right here. Can he target fire it down? He's going to have to run away. He will not get the snipe right away, and Enough looks like he will be able to secure this base, at least for the time being right now. But will Isaac just try to reposition and just go for another base? That's very likely. Scourger going to try to get in there, but will not connect. But even more Scourger coming in here. Can they connect? A couple of them do, but it doesn't look like anything did die. But any damage done is well needed for Isaac right now, as he doesn't seem to. He does not think he can engage right now with this pure meatless army right now, right here. He's going to be going for this 2 o'clock position. Can he break through these 5 spores? No, he will just kill off 2 spores and then run away. What he may hope in doing that is to kill off the 2 spores so they have to be remade, which in turn is going to affect his gas income for the time being. But he's just kind of sending out these like 12, these like packs of 12 Scourge, packs of a dozen Scourge, and just to see if they can do anything. But Isaac needs to do something happen right here. He had a really good early game, but Enough has just been able to get away with these bases with really keen defense going on right now. It's very surprising, I mean, how large this map is. Very good air defense for sure. Oh, here we go. That's just so much stuff going on here. It looks like it's just A-moving. Just going to be going in here trying to kill off that 4 o'clock position right here. But it looks like Enough going to be coming from the north. A couple Scourge are connecting, killing off a couple of the Devourers right now. And it looks like he's just killed off a couple drones right there. Isaac is going to be, maybe he could attack the 6. You may not know it, but he could attack the 6 right now. Did he kill off everything that Enough had, though? If that's the case, then well done by Isaac. Even more Scourge are going to be coming out here. Those Scourge packs are going to be able to do a good amount of damage. Oh, at the 6 o'clock position, commentator buddy. He's attacking that right now. And it looks like on the mini-map you can see Enough going to be coming there to help reinforce right there. But he doesn't kill it off. He must know that they're coming down. He doesn't want to get himself trapped right there. This guy, I mean, Isaac is very cautious. Extremely cautious, even. I'm not sure if he realizes, but I feel like he could probably just win. I mean, there's not a whole hunt. I mean, I haven't seen a huge part of Enough's army right now. They're the Devourers, but can he just kill them off on the retreat? Asmules are gonna be faster. Oh, look at the Scourge hits! It looks like Isaac can go in here. Enough looks like he's gonna GG, and there it is. Well played by Isaac. Allowing him to go, and Isaac's gonna be nice. Enough is like, what's going on here? He's just like, whoa. He's unhappy. Isaac must be pretty happy for that win. Well deserved. Well deserved. Good job. I would probably be pushing across the table and just be like, why did you win? But well played by Isaac. Guys, we'll be back momentarily for game 2 of day 1 of round of 8. Peace, guys.